Okay. What's your answer?
My answer is no.
No, I'm sorry. That's wrong. No, no. I think that, well, if it's right, then we need to provide a sequence that proves it.
Okay.
So what are you thinking?
Well, I was thinking actually something very similar to what we just saw.
Okay.
So tit for tat, what they're going to do is they're going to do cooperate, right? That's what they normally want to do.
Exactly.
So what would happen if at one point one of them defected?
Okay, just for simplicity, let's make it the very first point.
Mm-hmm.
So tit for tat number one defects, and tit for tat number two also defects?
At the very first time, no, it cooperates because it's done at the same time.
Well, I mean, so we can feed it anything we want. So we could tell tit for tat two to cooperate. It's sort of like we've taken over its brain for a brief amount of time.
So I'm not yet convinced it's going to matter for this. But the thing is that from that point on, tit for tat two is going to want to, for the next step, tit for tat two is going to want to defect.
That's right.
And tit for tat one would want to cooperate.
Uh-huh.
And that sort of sucks for tit for tat two, right?
So, I don't know. So maybe we should try to think through what is the expected reward for tit for tat two to actually do this defect at this time? To stick with the tit for tat machine at this time.
Well, what's going to happen at that point is it's going to keep alternating.
That's exactly right. So it's going to get the rewards corresponding to D versus C, C versus D, D versus C, C versus D.
Over and over again.
Yeah. So let's think about in the average reward case. So in the D versus C, if it does D when the other machine does C, then it gets 0.
Mm-hmm.
If it does C when the other one does D, it gets -9.
Mm-hmm.
And then this alternates.
Yep.
So if we look at the average reward, which is basically what you get when the discount factor is very, very high,
mm-hmm.
it's scoring -4.5.
Right.
Is there any way that it could behave against tit for tat, starting from this point, that would do better than -4.5?
Just go ahead and cooperate.
Just cooperate forever.
Well, cooperate the next time, and then keep doing tit for tat from that point on. It'll work out to be cooperate forever.
On average, that's right, which will get us a -1. So not being tit for tat at that point, but instead turning to always cooperate, would actually get it better. So the idea that it should defect at this point is an implausible threat.
Exactly.
So this is not subgame perfect. So yes, you nailed it.
Yay.
Does that make sense?
It did make sense.
Good. All right. So that leaves open the question of, is there a way to be subgame perfect in Prisoner's Dilemma?
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Before you answer that? So I had sort of convinced myself that it didn't matter whether tit for tat number two started out with C or started out with D. And I'm trying to decide whether that's actually true.
Okay, that's a good question. So what will happen at this from this point on, if we now continue, we took over the brains of tit for tat and we forced them to play defect against defect. And now mm-hmm. we release that and we let them do whatever it is that they're going to do. And what are they going to do is
they defect,
defect
forever. Yeah.
And is there anything that tit for tat 2 machine could do to get a better score than that?
Cooperate.
Yeah, so it could cooperating with tit for tat will bring it back into mutual cooperation. It will actually get a better score.
Yeah.
So in one case, it would average to -1, and the other one, it would average to -3, and -1 is better. So you're right. Good point.
Okay.
So really what matters is that we get them defecting.
Right. Okay, so that makes sense. So I was right that it didn't matter, although you do get slightly different answers or slightly different averages.
That's right. But in both cases, there's a way of getting a higher average.
Right. Okay, cool. That's what I thought. I thought it was something like that. So now let's go back to what you wanted to do. So are we going to be able to figure out how to do Prisoner's Dilemma in a way that is subgame perfect?
Well, how about I propose a machine and we'll see what it does.
Okay.